Welcome back, Robin here, and this is the channel where you get the update info on the day the update is released. Well, hopefully more often than not. And today we want to talk about the release of Final Cut Pro 10.7, where Apple has added some new features as well as minor improvements and fixes. This time around, I'm going to make several shorter videos for each feature instead of one really long one. If you want to see all the new features, just check the channel for the 10.7 playlist or click up here. And hey, if you like what you see and find something in this or any of my other videos helpful, give us a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button to not miss more update videos. It really helps the channel. So in this video, I'm going to start at the top of the list and show you the auto-scrolling timeline, a feature that, as currently implemented, actually only solves about half of what I was personally hoping for. Let me explain. So as any Final Cut Pro user, at least until yesterday, will know, until now, if you had a long timeline like this one and hit Command Plus a few times to zoom in to see more detailed audio waveforms and film strips, and you hit play, the playhead would start from wherever it is, run all the way to the right side of the timeline window, and simply disappear. At this point, to get it back into view, you had two different options. You could either simply stop playback, at which point the timeline would jump to wherever the playhead is to once again recenter it to the timeline window, and all the waveforms and film strips would refresh. Your other option would be to manually scroll sideways during playback with, for example, a magic mouse or any other mouse that allows for horizontal scrolling to keep it in view. The only issue with this was and is that neither the waveforms nor film strips outside of the scope of the initial clips that were showing in the timeline before beginning playback would refresh. So, again, you needed to stop the timeline to get the desired visual feedback. Actually, the only thing that I personally ever wanted or needed for audio waveforms, but not so much for the video film strips. So now, starting with version 10.7, there's the auto-scrolling timeline. To activate it, you simply go into the Final Cut settings and under the Playback tab. And here you'll find a new checkbox at the very top of the Playback section for scroll timeline continuously during playback. If I activate this, close the settings window, and return to my timeline, if I position the playhead all the way to the left of the timeline and hit the spacebar to resume playback, you'll see the playhead move as before to the right, but once it has reached the center, the timeline begins scrolling to keep the playhead centered to the timeline window at all times. And as you can see, as the clips further down the timeline scroll into view, their film strips and waveforms are continuously redrawn. In fact, if you hit the J key to play backwards and the playhead reaches the left of the timeline, it auto-scrolls to the right. This, for me, is by far the most elegant implementation of a scrolling timeline that I personally know of in any NLE. Because even if I'm playing back the timeline and decide to fast forward a bit by clicking somewhere to the right of the center, Final Cut will not abruptly jump the timeline to the left to center it again, as I know pretty much every other NLE does. And I'm very glad, because I find that to be extremely jarring and visually disorienting, as I think you'll see in a moment. I can also command plus and minus to zoom the timeline in and out as it's scrolling, and it will hardly miss a beat or jump around. Probably one, if not the reason, why I never felt I wanted this feature to begin with when seeing how it worked elsewhere. I guess I should have known better with Apple. As opposed to others that I know of, Final Cut will either stop scrolling if left from center, or even slightly speed up the scrolling if right from the center of the timeline window to catch up with the playhead to eventually position it in the middle of the timeline once again. Either way, anywhere I click during playback, be it left or right, Final Cut won't stop playback, which I find really annoying with others, along with the static always in the middle thing. I can still scroll left and right within the boundaries of the playhead without the timeline doing anything weird. Again, something that other editing apps do not allow you to do. For example, Premiere Pro. With its auto-scrolling active, if I click to the right while playing back, it stops. If I click the left, it sometimes jumps, sometimes it doesn't, but hey, at least it doesn't stop. And never mind trying to manually scroll left and right while it's playing, then it gets really weird. So, can you see why I at least knew I never wanted this? The wonderfully smooth way that Final Cut handles scrolling the timeline altogether is second to none as far as I'm concerned. By the way, how smoothly this will work for you will, of course, depend on various criteria. First and foremost, which Mac you are using, and especially the speed of the disk from which Final Cut is reading the library. But also on whether you have your timeline playback quality set to better quality or better performance. Or if your timeline is rendered or mostly unrendered, in which case it may well tend to jitter during the unrendered sections of the timeline. And of course, the more complex your timeline is, for example, if it has a lot of high resolution or overlapping clips, graphics, effects, etc., the more likely it is to struggle with the real-time scrolling and refresh. So you want to keep those points in mind. Okay, so why did I say that this only solves half of what I personally would have liked to see? Why will I probably not have this active as much, if at all, as it currently works? Well, while this is again the most useful and elegant implementation I've seen, it doesn't address one thing, namely a refresh at all times. Let me show you what I mean.
As I showed you, while the auto-scrolling is active, I can still manually scroll left and right. Everything will refresh just fine. But what if I want to jump ahead further than the current zoom level can fit into the window? In other words, if I want to scroll to the left past the position of the playhead so it's not visible anymore. Well, it starts doing what annoys me so much about the way others have implemented this. It doesn't allow me to scroll to the right any further when the playhead hits the left edge of the window, with which it starts doing this jumpy, jittery behavior, blocking me from scrolling beyond the current position of the playhead. Scrolling in the other direction results in the timeline jumping to the left to center the playhead. So basically, what I would like to see is the timeline refresh everything even when the auto-scrolling is inactive and I am scrolling manually. Because I will, in fact, sometimes scroll ahead to edit some audio before the playhead reaches it during playback without it stopping. Much harder to do without a refresh. Also, something that no other NLE will allow you to do as far as I've seen, and I absolutely love about Final Cut Pro. Super powerful. And for me personally, seeing the audio waveforms is far more important and useful than the film strips.
So, do you agree? Is there maybe a little tweak that you would like to see, or even something else? Then head over to the Final Cut feedback page and let them know, just as I did. Also, let me know in the comments what you think of the new scrolling timeline. Is it something you've been waiting for a long time? Do you think it's as elegant and well done as I do, apart from some details? Will you use it? Let me know. I'm always curious to hear how other people use features and functions in Final Cut. Maybe in ways that I've never thought of that would be useful to me and others. Thanks for watching, and if you liked what you saw and learned something, you might want to show your appreciation by clicking the like button and maybe even subscribing. And be sure to press the little bell because I have more update videos ready for you that you won't want to miss. Or maybe one of these videos has what you're looking for. Take care and hope to see you in the next one.